Welcome back. To shed more light on the Economic Conference Egypt 2022, which is providing a roadmap for the future of economy in Egypt, we have the pleasure to have this phone with Dr. Sayed Al Khouli, Professor of Economics at Ain Shams University. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Well, sir, the last session and the closing session of the conference took place today. This is a three-day conference. In the last session, President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi delivered a long speech and before the session and read the recommendations of the sessions of the conference. Could you give us your insight concerning the last speech of the president and the most important points that he spoke about?
First of all, I really congratulate the President Sisi and the government with Dr. Mustafa Mabouli for a very successful conference to gather people from all different fields in one place in order to discuss the economical development and economical problem and solution. And today with President Sisi's speech, he came for Egyptian people, yes, where he's looking forward in order in the future to have a better quality of life for Egyptians. And all of that will be able to reduce our unemployment rate. We are going to be able to attract more foreign direct investment from all over the world. Remember, President Sisi, he didn't take a look at the coronavirus crisis or the war between Russian and Ukrainian as a threat. He took it as an opportunity for Egyptian people, for Egyptian country, to attract more foreign direct investment and local investment to feed our industrial sector. Egypt in the future will be able to be a hub for industrial for industry from all over the world because of its location, because of its resources, mineral resources, and all our resources available in Egypt, and will be able to achieve what President Sisi mentioned in his final speech today.
Yes.
His purpose or his reasoning is to improve the quality of life for Egyptian people. And he will do it, and he will do it in a very near future, inshallah.
Yes, yes. So, Dr. Khouli, how do you see the importance of the timing of this conference, not only with its aim to provide a roadmap for the future of Egyptian economy, but actually it reviewed the success that Egypt have achieved concerning the file of economy, as we have witnessed recently high revenues for example, high revenues of the Suez Canal, high income of the tourism sector, and both the Suez Canal and the tourism sector are the national income of Egypt. And several fields and files we have witnessed a leap during the past few years. What's your comment on this?
First of all, I'm not going to talk about the local indicator. I'm going to talk about financial indicator worldwide.
Yes.
The financial institution worldwide, okay, like Standard & Poor's, like Fitch, International Monetary Fund, International Bank, European Bank for Development, all of these indicators shows Egypt in the positive side, and Egypt is developing, and the growth rate is going to be, as we mentioned by Dr. Maid a couple of days ago, it's 6.6, and it will be over 7 in 2023. All of that is a good news with revenue from Suez Canal, from tourism, and also President Sisi, he focused in a very serious way in developing our industrial sector. Remember, there is no replacement or no maintenance for our industrial sector for the last 50 years. It's going to attract the fourth industrial revolution technology with the new know-how in order to advance our industrial sector. Our resources, which we saw a week ago with the black sand, for example, which it used to be exported by for a very, very few dollars, and we then imported back with millions, billions of dollars. And President Sisi focused in our resources, raw material,
yes,
and how to maximize the added value for our resources. President Sisi is looking forward in order to invest in all different governments, and especially in Sinai, we'll see a lot of minerals, a lot of resources. It will be utilized in the very near future. Also, President Sisi focused in integrating our private sector with our public sector in order to add value for our economic. The misuse of our resources, it leads to low growth, but he's working very hard in order to get the maximum and more efficient our resources. And all of that with attracting internal investor and external investment, it will be able to be the hub for industrial sector and the agriculture sector in Egypt in the very near future. The conference spoke about our financial resources, talk about monetary resources. As we saw yesterday, our focusing on our stock market and the investment in Egypt. And of course, there is a lot of different viewpoints, and he will take it in his consideration, and the government will take it in the consideration. This brainstorming between industrial sector and the government, it will bring a lot of out-of-the-box solutions in order to make Egypt better in the future.
Yes, yes. Doctor, in several occasions, and especially in during this economic conference, Egypt 2022, the president stressed on the importance or the great role played by the private sector. What's your comment on this?
Private sector worldwide considered to be a very important partner in order to increase our growth rate. So we've been really separated the government from the public sector, and now as a result of this conference, we'll be able to integrate our private sector with the public sector. And remember, there is a lot of misused public resources which it turned out to be providing us with a very minimal income.
Yes.
Now we are going to better use it in the future.
Yes. So the private sector plays a great role in the economy of Egypt, isn't it?
As President Sisi mentioned, we yes. should put all Egyptians hand on hand in order to see Egypt in better place, whether it's the private sector, whether it's public citizen, whether it's foreign direct investment. We should look for all avenues, for all tools in order to enhance our economical system in the future.
Yes,
it's not only the role of the government, it's not only the role of the president, but the role for all Egyptians. And yes. let me say it in one word. President Sisi is our leader, and we are behind him.
Yes.
Whenever he asks, the Egyptian people will do it in the very near future.
Yes, yes, yes.
And that is the aim and the role of leadership in order to gather people together for the economic summit, for the dialogue, for all different political parties. A couple of months ago, and started to have a dialogue among all different factions of whether it is all different sectors in Egypt in order to unite Egyptian people. We all Egyptians is united, and all different parties are united in order to achieve the vision or Egypt Vision 2030, which is represented a few years ago, and we are going in the right direction.
Yes.
Let me say one important thing. Egypt, it will be in a different place worldwide by next few months. In next year, we'll see 2023, we'll see Egypt, inshallah, it will be in a different place in the world map.
Yes, how can the state back the partnership with the private sector as one of the aims planned by the holding of the conference, the economic conference Egypt 2022?
remember the partnership between the public sector and private sector.
Yes.
It needs a new regulation. Remember, we are working in public sector for the law of 72, which is about 50 years ago. We should really make a new regulation. The Congress and the Senate of Egypt has to work very hard in order to issue a new regulation, new laws, in order to facilitate and ease up this partnership and ease up the investment law in Egypt.
Yes.
In order to simplify the process, we have to really work hard in order to simplify, to get a license for the new business. And instead of taking months, it should take hours. And that is regulation, that is law, and we have to work very hard in order to simplify this process in order to attract more and more internal investor and external investor at the same time.
Yes. Doctor, how do you expect new economic measures to attract investors and investment to Egypt?
First of all, in order to attract foreign direct investment, first of all, it requires a leadership, and we have the leadership of President Sisi. Second of all, the logistic, all the infrastructure, and all the power supply needed for foreign direct investment is available, and we have excess capacity from our power supply and exported to different countries.
Yes.
That is very important for investors. For investor, it needs a new regulation, new simplified process, a new tax reform in our tax system in order to reduce the tax for small business as well as medium-sized business and make a project in Egypt. We have to give incentive for internal investor and external investor in order to facilitate and bring more and more foreign direct investment.
Yes, yes. Well, Dr. Sayed Al-Khouli, Professor of Economics at Ain Shams University, thank you very much for joining us over the phone. Ladies and gentlemen, a short break and I'm going to be back with you.